So it is said to be a truth, what we are going to talk about. These new principles have to be truth, providing a guide to thought and action. So are we developing a thought here? Definitely. And it had to be put it on practice and action. So this is very important. Without that, we don't succeed in our principles, which are going to be inculcated in your thoughts for the future. It must be observed that principles in management are derived out of experience. Now here, you have who are going to give lectures, your FMB manager, your room division manager, your sales manager, your HR manager, the general manager. They are the people who are going to give you. So the new principle, what I am going to come, is through experience, just not through a book. We are talking about day-to-day activities, what is happening. So it is important, it is to understand, it is more easier to learn than going into a class and learning. Okay? And the second one, principles in management are relative. I told you everything is taken as relative. Relative to last year, relative to budget. We talk about all, we are talking relativity. Okay, we relate non-operation, operation. You understand me? We take the relationships of every figure, every action, and should be attempted in light of organizational needs. And these relationships to be gathered and found out differences and find how to develop the thought to eliminate gaps will be done with scientific thinking. So it is for organizational need. What is the organizational need? Increase the sales, reduce the cost, maximize the profit. This is the management main objective. The second one, as I said, is every asset of the organization should have a longer life and a happier life. Even a coffee machine. You understand me? He should have a happier life. What is the happier life of a coffee machine? Is to give as much coffee to people. You understand me? That is the happiest life. And giving him quality, the machine. So it can be maintained only through looking at organizational needs. Now, in this principle, I developed expected 4 revolutions to do by this training course. It is even in our accounting package, these values are rare. Now, first one is technology revolution. We cannot improve our technologies unless otherwise we have a team of people who know to operate. We put a POS machine by the bank. Before you put it, you have to train people. So you are going to learn about how to give credit through banks, credit cards. So that learning process will give you new technology to come into the organizational need, which is to have better technology in the organization. So market revolution. What is market revolution? This is what you talk about. The question is all about market revolution. In order to get the best proportion from market to us, how do you do that? In order to be ahead of competition. You don't do things that others do. You do something better than others. And you give the customer experience. You take the customer, once he enters the organization, through an adventure of staying in a hotel. A novel experience. This is what is market revolution is all about. And then the marketing and sales team is go and guarantee. They are going to guarantee that you have an adventure in my organization. You can have an experience in my organization. Come and experience it. This is how the market revolution takes place. So in order to do that, you have to be creative. You have to be subject to change. You have to accept change. You have to be innovative. This is for sure. Without that, nothing will come. You have to be creative. Every time there is a creativeness. It cannot be only by the manager. It has to be by the level of supervisors. When you go, you have to go and keep this organization in a revolutionary manner, even you go and exhibit outside. we participate in Dai Fu. You have to go and exhibit it with creative knowledge to show we are in that. Knowledge revolution. This is what is taking place here. This is a new principle for this organization. All this time, we were working on the market, we are working on technology, but without these two cannot vibrate as well. If you take this one principle out, the others will not work properly. Managerial revolution. What is managerial revolution? Well, one would say managerial revolution is to have better profits, higher sales. But for me, it is also which makes people happy. Who are the people? The people will be, more than anything, the owners who started the organization should be happy. This is a managerial role, to have better profit for them. Then the customer. Customer should be happy. When you have good technology in the organization, definitely he will be happy. It is the same thing when he is informed. Uninformed, no customer will come. So marketing revolution have to take place. Knowledgeable employees give the best service. Best service. So customer is also. What about the employees? Which employee don't like to use the latest technology? Take your telephone, the best example. Sometimes general manager is using 3-year-old telephone, but a waiter or a bellboy is using the latest telephone. Why? There is a hunger to have the latest technology. So you can motivate employees giving technology. Manager accepting you as part of the team of management is one way of revolutionizing organizations. This is what we are believing about. Nothing can work without knowledge. Knowledge is the other one. This is what we are going to do on our training program. Thanks to many devoted managers, we will succeed in a short period of time, bring this revolutionary idea of training employees. This has not been there in the past, in this organization or many organizations. We believe every single employee have the capacity to change and grow. Capacity to change and grow in their life. Let's see, by theory, Henry Fayol, Principles of Management, he says, division of work. Just a few minutes ago, I went on the uniform system of accounts, structure. Did we divide our work? We divide according to their specialities, and we talk about increase of efficiency. Did we talk about it? Yes. Without effective and efficient management, you don't reach our principles. In order to achieve our principal goals, you have to work on specialization, divisional work, increase the efficiency of the organization. Let's go to another one. Authority and responsibility. Both should go hand in hand. What we do by department wise, we break the organization and give each manager responsible for that organization. The organization of what we saw it in the statement of income, each of them have a manager. Correct? By having a manager, what did we do? We give them responsibility. And we must give them authority to the size of his responsibility, not more than that. By this way, now you will be learning soon, in focus when you do, it's called the internal control of the organization. What is internal control of the organization? One's responsibility is not being disturbed by another. Okay, so not disturbed by another. This should be always controlled by another. Okay, that is what you will learn on internal control. Nothing goes free hand. Nothing goes carte blanche. One person will. It is controlled by another. You will be learning when it comes to further training about internal control. Unity of command. An employee should receive orders from one supervisor only for any action or activity. Nobody likes to have many commanding you what to do. That is also structured to uniform accounting system. It's the uniform accounting system is not only an accounting system, it's an organization system. It is built on the organization by many of the experience that they gathered in hotel industry for a long period of time. They have come with a uniform system of accounts. That uniform system of accounts, what the chart you saw, is giving that how the organization goes, chain of command, how the orders are given. It is all classified under that. So accounts is not just merely figures. It is all a management method. It's a management method. So let me see how it works. What is principle of Merkew statement of income? You saw the statement of income. Okay? Decision of the hotel, divisions of the hotel, we thought about it. It is division of the hotels are having cost centers. What is cost centers? For example, F&B department. Total sales is coming from not one department, one cost center. There are many cost centers which generate income. For example, different coffee shops, banqueting, and outside catering, the bars, all that comes part of the cost centers which gives you divisional income. Okay? And they have a departmental objective. We talk about trying to be less or more by the last year, achieving the budget, each department of each cost center to reach the target. These are the objectives to me. And the total objective is to have a profit of each outlet. But you have different targets to meet, daily targets, shift by target to reach. To reach the total figure, you have to work by targets. And in order to do that, operational and non-operational targets are set. And divisional wise, we talk about responsibilities. And it should be properly defined who is responsible, what to be done. These are the things you, in the course of action, you will be learning. And how do you share? How do you share? You have to inform on time. For example, you go to a room to clean. You find the switch is out of order. You should inform the maintenance department. Even though it is a non-operational department, you should inform on time. If the guest comes and he experiences a bad thing, he runs away from the organization. By he going out, you lose even the income. So shared knowledge is very important. Sharing operational and non-operational organization is very important. Maximizing income. We saw it in the P&L. Maximizing income is the objective to reach. Achieving market share. We talk it. You cannot maximize the income by not focusing on the market share. This is what one asks. How do we penetrate the market? So we must know. Penetrating the market is by giving the experience that others don't give. This is the major objective. Once you give one, others will copy. Then you have to find another one. See how the whole journey is. So this, without this, you cannot get a market share. By going and saying, I have a hotel, it doesn't work. It has to be differentiated by others. And better yield to reach. What is better yield? Bringing, I said, room income, you will also achieve F&B income. So, for example, some of the airline business is linked with total package. Some of the long-staying guests is with the total package, room plus F&B. So, you have to look at that. Then, minimizing expenses is a goal to reach. Even we're talking about statement of income. Taking care of assets is a very important thing on the department wise. All of your department have your assets. You have to look after the assets. Employees of the organization is also asset. You have to look after them. You have to make them happy. Those are the objectives of the supervisors and managers. And you work with better margins. In order to reach the best goal, you have to work with better margins. Better profitability comes from comparative figures. You cannot say better unless you compare it. Correct? So you have to compare with last year figures and budgetary figures and say we have better figures. Okay? And you have to find, you cannot go to, you can make good profit by doing illegal activities. You understand?